Mark, you said here in São Paulo AWS Summit event that we are living in disruption times. It's not just one time, but it's constantly. So my question is how companies can address this kind of challenges?
Yes. What's interesting is that it's not just a single disruption these days. It's an atmosphere of constant change for companies and constant surprises. I mean, we see geopolitical changes, we see changes in technology, we see pandemics and wars in Ukraine, so many things. And so companies have to learn to be able to respond to these disruptions and yet at the same time to grow, continue growing just as companies. So the danger is if they become defensive and they only step back when there's a disruption and cut costs and things like that, well, they won't be able to grow because there are so many disruptions. So I spoke about how they can think about continuing to grow, continuing to operate, even as they manage to be resilient to the disruptions they're seeing.
And another disruption will came from AI generative. How should we live with both this way and how AI, generative AI will change even more, not only companies, across industries and the society?
Yes, some disruptions are scary, but some are wonderful. Generative AI poses so many possibilities for companies. And so many possibilities for the world, too, I think. Of course, there are dangers, and companies have to use it responsibly, but the potential is just enormous. So what we try to do at AWS is to, we say, democratize the technology, just as we democratize the cloud. We want to make it available to all companies, not just the companies that can hire the AI experts and spend a lot of money. And we want to make it available to as many of their employees as possible, too. And the reason why that's so important is because the success that companies have with generative AI will depend on their ability to innovate with it. They need to manage for innovation, and usually that means they want employees to have ideas, and they want to be able to test them and use the technology in a way that reduces their risk and reduces their costs and increases their speed.
And when combined cloud computing and artificial intelligence, both the normal one, the traditional one, and the generative AI, what potentials that comes up from that?
Well, AI depends on data. That's where it starts, right? That's what it operates on. And in the cloud, we've had tremendous success helping our customers use data, find ways to access data, to collect data, to store the data, to manage access and control privacy with data. And in the cloud, we have that possibility of combining the effective use of data with these new tools of generative AI and maybe the older tools of AI and machine learning that have been around for a while as well.